Hello everyone, my name is Zhifeng Chen from University of Southern California. Today I will introduce my work of synergistic combination of golden angle radio sampling and dual subspace modeling for rapid and robust high spatial temporal resolution MRI. I have nothing to disclose. It is well known that ASL-based dynamic MRI is an emerging tool in characterizing dynamic flow patterns, which plays an important role in the diagnostic and treatment of cerebrovascular diseases. In this work, we use pulsed ASL scheme for ASL-based MRI data acquisition. Label and control ASL data were sampled using golden angle radio trajectory with a stack of stars partition by partition manner. Here is the image reconstruction flowchart of dual subspace MRI, which consists of three parts: low resolution image reconstruction with temporal and phase TV constraints, principal component analysis for the main components, and high resolution image restoration using subspace concepts. Here are the main principal components of low resolution reconstructed images. We can see that the main energy is distributed in the first few principal components. In this work, the ASL-based dynamic MRI imaging was performed on a 3T Prisma MR scanner using a 20-element head coil array. A parcel-prepared two-phase sequence was employed for this acquisition. The relevant parameters are as the following. Here are the 20-spoke per-frame image reconstruction results, corresponding to 13-fold acceleration. It can be clearly seen that the proposed dual subspace MRI has the highest image quality among all the tested approaches. In addition, the signal intensity time causes prove that the proposed scheme don't induce temporal resolution loss. Here are 26 fold acceleration corresponding to 10 spoke per frame results. We can see that the proposed dual subspace MRI generates the best image quality among all the tested approaches. Here are the comparisons of single frame results. It can be obviously seen that the proposed dual subspace MRI has the best image quality among all the tested approaches. Therefore, we can draw the conclusion that compared to conventional eye grasp type techniques, including grasp and 5D grasp, the proposed dual subspace MRI offers better image quality, including higher SNR and fewer streaking artifacts, without temporal resolution loss. It has a latent advantage of better temporal resolution due to higher reconstruction accuracy. All in all, we can further draw the conclusion that the proposed dual subspace MRI will improve the clinical capability of high spatial temporal resolution dynamic MRI. Thank you for your attention. We are always open to questions and comments.